Welcome back to the channel. It's Brene, with No Juice. And today, I gotta talk to you. Let's go. Welcome back to the channel. You know how we do. We get down, get me back to act the fool. Okay. What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. It's your girl, Brene. Wow, it's been like months since I've uploaded. It's been a minute since I've been on here. It's been a minute since we kicked it. You've been caught up. That's for my Janae fans. Yeah, it's been a little minute, guys. I miss y'all. I mean, like, wow, it's been like months. But I'm finally back just to do a little talking, give you guys a little update on where I've been and what the heck's been going on in my life. It's been a lot, so. Without further ado, I guess let's just hop right into it. Okay guys, so life has been like super busy for me. It's been super transformative the last few months for me. It's just been a lot going on, to be honest. I mean, I guess I'll just hop right into this. To be honest, I've been dealing with a lot of like depression, like a lot, to the point where I kind of went into a hermit crab shell. I just stopped creating. I didn't want to do anything. I mean, I was still getting up every day and moving around, but as far as like creating, it's like I just wanted to pull back from creating. Some things happened behind the scenes and it was just like, I don't feel like it anymore. I don't feel like creating. I don't feel like pouring out. I wasn't in a space to share. I wasn't in a space to be a role model or be a big sister to you guys, or I just wasn't in that space to share, you know. And I think sometimes that happens in life. When I look at my journey, my creator journey, I've been creating and sharing of myself nonstop for like, 6 years, something like that, just straight, just no breaks. I mean, always uploading 2-3 times a week, just trying to stay consistent with things. So this was like the first really big break that I took, and I needed it actually. I had to like force myself because I started to feel bad. I'm like, dang, I'm not uploading, I'm not creating right now. Like, oh, I just need to do, let me just put a video out just because. And I was like, no, I'm not gonna do that. I'm not gonna force myself to share when I'm not in a place to share. So that's why you guys have not seen me. I've been really, really dealing with myself and just dealing with a lot of different things that I think needed to be addressed. So I'll start with, I've been in therapy, okay? So therapy is like awesome. It's like something that I think everyone should do. Therapy is like absolutely amazing. So I've been in therapy. And I've been in therapy probably for like, maybe like 5 months now. It's been like amazing. And in therapy, I've been able to visit a lot of my childhood traumas that I never realized affected me growing up. So one of the biggest childhood traumas that I've realized was like having to be perfect, having to be the perfect child, having to be the perfect role model, the perfect daughter, perfect big sister to my younger siblings, like just always having to be perfect in order to not necessarily receive love, but in order for my parents or whoever, my elders, not to be disappointed in me. And I realized that that was actually tied to purity culture as well. Y'all aren't ready for my videos next year. Like when January hits, we're really about to go ham, and y'all are probably gonna like be like, what the heck, like what is she on? But I just cannot wait to share with you guys what I've been learning and how I've been kind of like detaching myself from old thought patterns, detaching myself from old beliefs, detaching myself from traumatic and unhealthy ways of thinking. Like, I just cannot wait to share with you guys all that I've been learning on my own little journey. So yeah, I've been in therapy, and in therapy I've been, you know, retracing childhood traumas. I've been retracing how that has affected me in my marriage, how that affects me in my parenting style, like all of that good stuff. Along with that, we've been, you know, just, so since realizing that, dang, I'm kind of dealing with a little bit of depression, a lot of it is postpartum. You guys know I had a kid 2 years ago, and a lot of people think that postpartum depression happens just in the first couple months after you have a baby. Well, mine hit, and I've talked about this on my channel a little bit, but mine hit a little bit later. 2.5 years in, and like after going, breastfeeding, all that stuff, 2 years straight, it finally just like hit me like a ton of bricks. Like literally, I just felt like it just like was like rah, like it just took over me. So I think part of that is, so you guys know I weaned Enzo. I stopped breastfeeding him, and I'll probably do a video on that too, but I stopped breastfeeding him over the summer. And once I stopped breastfeeding him, I realized that like my hormones were just all over the place. Like they were everywhere. And I didn't correlate the two. I never realized like, okay, I stopped breastfeeding. That's why I'm feeling like this. I need to be taking more vitamins, or I need to be exercising, or making sure I'm getting sunshine, da 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 da. Because when you're breastfeeding, you get a lot of happy hormones, a lot of oxytocin, a lot of like good hormones, because it helps your milk flow. And so I never realized that, you know, once you start breastfeeding, you still have to deal with the regular hormones again, and then like your hormones being off balance and all the different stuff. So a lot of crazy hormones have been like raging lately, and I'm like, what is wrong with me? Like, this is not me. What is the problem? Like, I got an attitude. Like, I'm just annoyed with everything. Like, so therapy kind of helped me to realize that. So I got back on my vitamins. I'm feeling a lot better now. I'm kind of coming up out of it. As you can see, because I'm actually making a video, but I have not been in the space to share for a long time. And I just didn't feel like it was fair of me to get on the internet and cap. I'm not about to cap. Y'all know that. I like to keep it real, so I'm not gonna cap. I'd rather just not upload and do it like that, you know? So, I realized once I weaned Enzo that those hormones kind of got out of whack. They got a little bit all over the place, and that definitely affected me in a couple different ways. And so I'm finally getting to a place where I'm like, I'm feeling a little better. Things are looking a little better. I think I'm ready to kind of come back and touch on a lot of different subjects like that I've been realizing since being in therapy and just taking a step back. I've had time to think about some things. And so so you guys really liked my last video when I talked about regrets of being a virgin, right? You guys really liked that video. And so I have a lot more content like that coming up, I guess, just to kind of share some like deeper thoughts, like the real, real nitty gritty stuff that people don't talk about, that the church won't talk about, that you're not gonna hear on social media, you know? I think that's why a lot of you guys like click with me, is because I like to be honest and like to just like to keep it real as much as possible. So as beautiful as virginity is, and as beautiful as my journey has been, all that stuff, there's also another side to it that I didn't realize was affecting me, that I cannot wait to share with you guys. So I may or may not bring Andrew in on that topic. I don't know really where he stands right now with it. We kind of been discussing a little bit, so we'll see if he wants to hop in some of the videos, but I'm really definitely excited to share some of that stuff with you guys. But yeah, that's just a little recap of where I've been, what I've been doing. I've been momming. I've been, you know, motherhood. That is like a whole nother level. Like, I was not ready. Like, oh my God. Take your time, okay? Everybody be such in a rush to get married. Everybody's in a rush to have a kid. Everybody's in a rush to be in a relationship. Everybody's in a rush to be locked down. Like, take your time, okay? Like, motherhood is no joke. Being a wife is no joke. Like, it gets real. It gets tough. It gets deep. It's not just the pretty white dress and like, yes. You know, you guys have heard me talk about this before. Y'all know this ain't nothing new. Like, we've talked about those deep conversations before, but like, marriage is, it's a beautiful thing, but at the same time, it's hard work. Motherhood is a beautiful thing. At the same time, it's hard work. Parenthood is hard work. And my kid is in the terrible twos. I try not to call him terrible. Ooh. Enzo is literally off the chain. He's like off the chain. He's calming down a little bit now. The closer he gets to 3 years old, he'll be 3 in 3 months, or almost four months. So the closer that he gets to that, I'm kind of seeing him like calm down a little bit. I'm like, okay, I like this version of you. Can you just freeze time and stay right here? But those two, that like heavy nitty gritty 2 year old stage was like a lot. He's just now kind of coming out of that. Sometimes he sways back and forth between the two, and I'm like, dude, not today, not today. So if you guys follow me on Instagram, I know you guys have seen that I've kind of like pulled back on sharing Enzo and sharing Andrew on my page for a little bit, just because I'm going through kind of my own transformation, my own personal journey as a wife and as a mother and as a woman. And so, yeah, I've kind of pulled back from sharing certain things. And so I can't wait to get back to the place where I'm in a place to actually share. But yeah, these next videos that I'm gonna come out with next month, 2022, we're gonna talk a lot about sexuality, being comfortable in your sexuality, how purity culture affects the way that we view ourselves, how purity culture affects the way that we view other people, how it affects how we like, all of that stuff. I just literally cannot wait to dive into it. I think that it's gonna be an awesome discussion more than anything. Like, I don't want anybody to feel judged. I don't want anybody to feel like they're right or they're wrong. None of that. I just want to have like a really good discussion with you guys and just kind of share some of my thoughts. And discoveries. So yeah, that's where I've been. I've been dealing with myself. I've been growing. I've been learning. This has actually been a very positive place for me. I know when the word depression gets brought up, people always think, oh my God, depression. But depression doesn't always mean dark. Sometimes depression, like for me, can just mean a rediscovery of self. Going and figuring out, okay, why am I in this place? How did I get to this place? Okay, and then how do I get out of this place? And so that's kind of been for me, like, why do I feel like this? Okay, postpartum depression. Oh, I stopped breastfeeding. Oh, okay, I'm realizing that I've carried all this pressure all these years. Oh, maybe I've been oversharing too long. Maybe I need to just chill. Maybe I need a break. So yeah, depression for me is not just all this dark, just scary, like, oh, depressed, I stay in the bed all day stuff. No, it's just mostly been like self-discovery, rediscovery, figuring out where I wanna be, where am I going in life, where's my course turning, you know? And I think everybody needs to have that defining moment sometimes. Sometimes we have multiple defining moments like that, like what's next in life? And so that's where I've been, just on a journey of rediscovery, a journey of just finding myself again. Because once you get married and you have a kid, you lose yourself. At least that's been my experience. I lost myself a lot. Like, big part of me was lost. My individuality, what I love to do. You guys know I'm a musician. I'm a singer, songwriter first. That's my heart. I love music, and I stopped doing music for a long time. Part of that wasn't just because I got married or had a kid. A lot of that was I went on The Voice, and then that was a whole other experience that we don't have to talk about. But yeah. So yeah, that's where I've been. But I'm ready to come back. I've been doing a lot of traveling. Like a lot of traveling. I'm literally about to hop on a plane tomorrow, go out of town for my best friend's birthday. She's turning 30, so we're about to town for a little bit. But yeah, I've been traveling, I've been living life. Like, life is literally, it's been good when I think about it. It's been good, but it's also been like a mix of growth. And that's what I'm most excited about, is growing. So I love you guys. Thank you guys so much for sticking around. If you watch this video, I truly, truly do appreciate you. For being here during my hiatus, you know, like, I notice a lot of YouTubers, after a while, they get to a point where they just have to clock out for a couple months, and I think that it makes sense. You know, I never understood it before. I'm like, dang, she ain't uploading forever. I'm mad at her. I'm unsubscribing. And it's like, yeah, no, that's not how you treat people. People are people. People are humans. They go through things behind the scenes that you will never know about. And I think it's just important to show love, show support. So for the people that are still around, you're just a part of my tribe. That means you're meant to be here, and I appreciate you, and I cannot wait to see you guys. 2022, these videos are really about to be off the chain. So if you're ready, like, make sure you stick around. I love y'all, and I'll see you soon.